If you want to learn how to measure and plot temperatures, build wireless radio controllers, use servos to drive tools, or build weird things like, I don't know, a thermal camera, here, you'll learn mechatronics in minutes. Last week, we got a taste of working with LCD displays, and this week, we'll discuss how to save data like settings without having to mess around with SD cards. Some good examples are calibration values, color settings, IDs, and more. Many of my projects save things like voltage divider calculation values, stepper motor distances, and device IDs for sensors around my home monitoring system. Fortunately, in most MCUs, there's a special type of memory intended for this purpose and is called an EEPROM, which stands for Electrically Erasable Programmable Read-Only Memory. Wait a minute, that doesn't make any sense. If it's read-only, how can you program it? Leave a comment if you know. You can write data to this memory and it's retained on power down, so no battery backup or auxiliary power is needed. While there are a few methods on the EEPROM object, the ones I use exclusively are put and get. The argument list for put and get is pretty simple. Pass in an address and a variable. One word of caution, the default data in an EEPROM is null, so you will have to initialize it by writing some data before getting anything. EEPROMs can store just about any type of data, such as bytes, ints, floats, longs, chars, and more. If you have to save a char, make sure you define a known char length, as you will need to get the data with that same char length. I've never tried storing a string data type, but you shouldn't be using strings anyway. Alright, let's take a quick look at the code here. If you're going to write to your EEPROM, you're of course going to need to include the EEPROM.h library that should ship with most platforms. I've got a couple of variables, a simple tester byte variable, some chars. I'm going to be doing some timing tests here and a float for some calibration data. Of course, you're going to have whatever variables that you want to store in your EEPROM designated accordingly. I am on a TNC 3.2 now, so we're going to wait for the serial monitor to fire up. You won't need to do this on an Arduino, but just keep that in mind that you'll need to do this for a TNC. First example here is just writing a simple number, like calibration data or a color setting or something like that. I'm going to store this in address 490. I've got 2K to worry about, or I should say work with, and I'm at this address. So first we're going to try to get it. First of all, you're going to be able to get it no matter what, whether it's unpopulated, fresh EEPROM or not. I'm going to dump that in a byte called tester, as you saw earlier. If tester equals 255, that means that data has never been written to and you can't do anything with it. The infamous isNaN, isNaN, is not a number, could also be used for this. I'm not sure it's supported on all platforms, though. This seems to be a pretty reliable test here. If it's 255, I'm going to alert the user that there's no data there. I'm going to populate it with some default data. And I'm going to put that right in address 490, and there's the argument of 490. If it was not 255, just go ahead and get it, because you know you have valid data in there. And you'll see the code run in here in a second, and you can see how the data at address 490 is going to be whatever that calibration data happened to be. If you want to write a char, it's very, very similar. There's a couple ways that you can do the test. First, I'm going to try to get the text right out of the EEPROM. Keep in mind, the read text here, as it was defined up here, is 20 characters. I've also got a DS text and a buffer of 20 characters. You have to know that length. Your read and write has to be the same length, otherwise you're going to get some garbled text or nothing at all. So we're going to read the EEPROM out of address 495 right into the read text, and if the byte value of the very first character is 255, we know that's not valid data. So I'm going to put my DS text in there, which was, I forgot, the cat in the hat. So if that was not 255, or at least the first byte value, and this may not be the most reliable test, but I'm testing the first byte, and if it's valid, then you probably have a good char. Then just simply read it out of address 495, and then go ahead and display that text, or put it on a button, or you know whatever you have to do with that text. Could be a password or something like that. If you want to change that text, you can't update the read text directly. If you've ever worked with chars, you have to use strcopy to copy some kind of text into that buffer, and that buffer can get stuffed into address 495. And then we're going to turn around and get it right out of 495 and then print that right to the screen to see what it says. Again, you're going to see all this run in just a second. If you want to see what the EEPROM timing tests are, to put a byte, I'm going to put that in address 0. We're going to measure the time. Then I'm going to put a float, and we're going to get the time. I'm going to put it and get it for a float, a byte, a float, and 20 characters. So we can see what all of this will look like. So let's go ahead and run this code, and we'll see what this looks like down in the serial monitor. There was some data in address 490, and that's what it is. There was no char value at 495, so we populated that with the Cat in the Hat. We turn around and updated the data with Talk to Me Goose. And then you can see the timings for a put and a get for bytes, floats, and chars. Your type of MCU dictates how much EEPROM memory you have. Unos and Nanos have about 1K, but Teensies are 2K to 4K in size. You can't store program code inside of an EEPROM. One word of caution is that you can read and write to an EEPROM approximately 100,000 times before failure. One last note, it's good practice to write EEPROM data in the order of its address. Well, that covers this week's lesson. If you learned something, give me a thumbs up. If you have a tip to share, leave a comment so my subs can learn more. Thanks for watching.